Curious. Dragonfly TV.
Today on Dragonfly TV, you'll meet some kids who may someday affect your local forecast.
Exhibit 1, Alexa and Sullivan will show us how to make our own tornado.
Yes, you heard her right. They've got a mean funnel cloud going.
Tornadoes are the most powerful storm in nature, but no one really understands how they form.
And that's what makes tornadoes so hard to predict. Even storm chasers don't have them figured out.
Hi, my name is Sullivan, and I'd love to chase storms, but my mom says no way.
Sullivan, come back! It's too dangerous!
Moms, you're always messing up our fun. I'm Sullivan's friend, Alexa, and my motto is, when the tornado won't come to you, you go to the tornado.
Here at NCAR, they actually let you stand next to a tornado. This is the vortex. It's really cool. It shows how the winds form to make a tornado.
The funnel is the visible cloud portion of a tornado, but it's the wind swirl or vortex that's at the center of the storm. We wanted to know how fast those winds were, so we did a bit of research.
A good day to fly a kite is when the winds blow about 10 miles per hour.
During big thunderstorms, straight line winds can hit as high as 150 miles per hour. Hurricane winds can blow as fast as 200 miles per hour.
But a tornado has them all beat. Winds get as high as 300 miles per hour.
Yeah. The first time I saw the NCARS model, I thought it was so cool that I decided to build my own.
What is he building in there?
First, I put a pan of water over a hot plate to make steam, and then I put one fan over it. That didn't work at all. After a few more tries, I thought of using two fans, one to get the air really spinning and one to draw it up. Then, I used a cool mist humidifier to make the vortex visible. It was pretty hard to create a vortex. It's probably the same in nature, which may be why tornadoes are so rare. With my model here, we can get a better idea of how a tornado works. Alexa and I want to know if one wind is more important than the other wind in creating a vortex.
We can test this by adjusting the wind speed on the two fans.
The top fan has three settings, while the side fan only has two.
Sullivan and Alexa observed the tornado and estimated its F scale. Then we will measure the strength of the tornado by measuring the speed of the vortex.
Let's start this baby up. Both of our fans are set on low now, and it doesn't look like much is happening.
I'd say best force one, wouldn't you?
Less than force. Put force, force zero, because this isn't even a tornado.
Let's crank it up. Put it on a higher level.
Okay. Now we have the side fan on high, which should produce some sort of a vortex.
Trees are shaking a little.
Yeah, the trees are shaking. Let's call this an F1.
Okay.
Right now, here we are at round two. Just set that to medium, please. Okay, the vortex is trying to form without being disrupted.
Not too good, though.
Not too good. Okay, the updraft fan is set on medium, and the side fan is set on high. Oh, looks like one of the roofs off of the house is blown off.
Yeah, the anemometer's
spinning.
Wait a
minute. Two of the
buildings
high rises just blown over. Okay, the anemometer is spinning very slowly, and on the F scale, I'd say this is about an F2 because it pulled the roof off of one of the houses and knocked over two of the high rises. Almost looks like the tornado is trying to move things out of its way so it can form and have a little place for itself.
They tried setting the top fan to high and the side fan to low, but still only got an F2 tornado. Now it's time to set both fans to maximum power.
We've adjusted the settings, we've cranked the fans up, and we're ready for a force 5 tornado at night. Okay, here comes the vortex. Whoa, here it goes. Oh, look, all the buildings are off.
Yeah,
look,
blowing around.
Okay, this is definitely a force 5.
Let's analyze the data.
With the side fan on low, they got a weak vortex only when they turned the top fan to medium or high. So the updraft was important in those cases. Things got interesting after they cranked up the side fan, but the side fan by itself wasn't enough. Look at this result with the side fan on high and the top fan on low. They got only an F1 vortex. Then look what happened when they increased the top fan. At the medium setting, they got an F2 vortex. And when they made that updraft really strong, that's when they got an F5 tornado. So you definitely need a side wind, but it's the updraft that turns it into a destructive tornado.
I'd like to find out if our results are true in a real tornado. Someday I will chase a tornado and I'll find out for myself.
In the meantime, we know that the dangerous part of a tornado is the ground winds. That's the part that destroys houses, cars, and trees.
Hey Sullivan, what do you get when a tornado hits a bakery?
A cinnamon twist?
No, a funnel cake, of course.
Well, here's another recipe. How do you make Twister cookies?
I don't know.
Use tornado.
So Sullivan's model works kind of like the real thing.
But tornadoes are still not completely understood. Scientists do know that the winds inside and outside the funnel are moving at different directions and at different speeds.
Which is exactly what his model showed us. How sweet.
Yeah, and remember, Sullivan's model started as a little project. Check this one out.
All you need are two soda bottles and a connector. You can use duct tape.
If you're interested in storms, avalanches, or earthquakes, you can build your own model like Sullivan's too.
Yeah, and check out our website for more info. And tell us what you're up to, because that might be your ticket onto Dragonfly TV.
Let's go!
We're gonna have a little problem here. Thank you. Thing is right in our road.
My name is Howie Bluestein, and I'm a professor of meteorology, and I chase tornadoes. A meteorologist is someone who studies and or forecasts the weather.
Can you dig it?
Can
y'all dig it?
The word meteorologist comes from the word meteor, which means something falling from the sky. This is one of the largest hailstones ever documented. It takes a very large updraft flowing up in a supercell thunderstorm to keep something as heavy as this suspended in the air, and then eventually it becomes so heavy that it just falls to the ground. When I was a kid, a number of very exciting things happened to me that had to do with the weather. I remember one day I was watching television, and we had a big antenna outside the house, and lightning struck the antenna, and the TV blew up right in front of me. The fun part of what I do is never knowing what's going to happen.
There is a tornado dude right next to us. Which way is it going to go?
Stand by. I don't like the looks of this at all. Proceed with extreme caution. I don't want to get blown over here.
Holy cow!
Woo! We try to set things up so that the tornado will move at right angles to us.
Velvet black sky.
Sometimes we'll stay with the storm for as much as 5 hours, waiting for a tornado to occur.
Velvet black sky.
And we're targeting the storm right here to our right.
We make measurements with Doppler radar to measure the wind speeds in the tornado without getting into the tornado itself.
Zero visibility.
And we're going to need new air filters tomorrow again.
So you're seeing it, and you're also having fun trying to figure out how it works.
I'm only happy when it rains.
So Michael, what's next week's forecast?
I see cloud cover moving out to reveal fast-moving kids and high-adventure science.
Remember, this could include you. But if you don't tell us what projects you're up to, we may never find out.
Our website is the place to go.
To find out more about Dragonfly TV, head to PBS Online at pbskids.org. For more experiments, Dragonfly Magazine teachers' guides, and a place for you to send us your investigations. Or write us at Dragonfly TV, 172 East 4th Street, St. Paul, Minnesota, 55101.
The end of the show always makes you feel under the weather.
Just say goodbye, Michael.
Goodbye, Michael.
Investigations across the nation on Dragonfly TV.
Ciao for now.